Today I'm going to show you how you can make a super simple CO2 system that doesn't cost anything at all, is super easy to make, and it's going to give your plants a stable level of CO2 for at least 5 weeks. I actually already made a video about this a couple months ago, but that was one of my first YouTube videos, and I wasn't very comfortable in front of a camera, and there were still a few things missing in that video. So today we're doing it again. So when it comes to DIY CO2, a lot of people don't like it because it's a bit messy, it's unstable, and you can't turn it off. Yes, it has some downsides, but a professional CO2 system, yeah, it's just expensive, you know, it costs 100, 200 bucks easily. And a lot of people don't have that kind of money to spend on their hobby, you know, they want to keep things low budget. So for that kind of people, this sort of setup is perfect. So I've been using DIY CO2 for many years. I still use it today. The 20 liter cube is using DIY CO2, as well as the 10 liter cube on top. And the 20 liter cube is running for a year and a half already on DIY CO2. Super stable. I don't have any algae issues in there. Okay, so to make one of these systems, super easy. The only thing you need is two bottles, one larger one, one smaller one. You need some airline tubing. And you need a diffuser. That's all you need, basically. So this system right here is perfect for aquariums up to 60 liters. But really, you can make these CO2 systems as large as you want. Just take a larger container or take multiple containers. Doesn't really matter how big your aquarium is, you can make something like this. Okay, so let's go more in depth in how to make this. So we have two bottles, a larger one and a smaller one. The large bottle, that's going to be where our CO2 is going to be made. So we're going to fill this with a sugar mixture, and to that we're going to add yeast. And that's going to start fermenting. The yeast is going to start consuming the sugar, and in that process they're going to start making CO2 bubbles. So the CO2 is going to start rising to the top through the airline tubing into the second bottle. Now the second bottle is just filled with water, and the only purpose here is to basically clean the CO2. Because what's going to happen here, this is going to start fermenting, it's going to start bubbling, and some foam is going to create, and we don't want that in our aquarium, so we need to wash it. So CO2 is going to build up in here, it's going to go through the ears, and this airline is into the water, so if I squeeze this bottle, bubbles are going to start coming out. So the clean bubbles are going to rise to the top of the second bottle, and then they're going to go again through the airline to the diffuser. To put this whole thing together, the only thing we need to do, so you need to make some holes in these screw caps of these bottles. So the larger bottle only needs one hole, and the smaller bottle needs two. So the way that I like to make these holes is just by warming up a screwdriver or something similar, and just basically melt a hole in the screw cap. Now we want to make sure that these holes are not too big, because we want the airline to go through it, but it also has to be a tight fit. Now the easiest way to get this airline through that small hole is by cutting it at an angle and then using a plier or something similar to basically pull it through the hole. Now the first hose that goes through the washing bottle, we need to make sure that the tube goes into the water, because else it doesn't do anything, it doesn't wash. So that one needs to be a little bit longer, but for the rest the tubes can just be pulled like a small centimeter through the cap, that's enough. Now we really need to make sure that this whole system is airtight. So I always add a little bit of silicone glue to the tops of these screw caps. Because if we have only a tiny hole in here, it's not going to be able to build that much pressure to go through the diffuser. Now what makes this system long lasting, like up to 6 weeks, is the special ingredient in the sugar mixture. And to the sugar we add gelatin. So the whole point of this gelatin is basically to slow everything down. Because during the process, and the yeast also makes alcohol, but actually they can't really handle alcohol that well. So the more alcohol they make, the less CO2 they're going to produce. And at some point they're actually going to almost kill themselves because they make so much alcohol. So we want to slow that down. So by adding gelatin, we make it harder for the yeast to consume the sugar, and that way we just prolong the whole process. So the recipe for this sugar mixture is really simple. You just need 250 grams of sugar and 250 grams of water. And to that we're going to add 3 sheets of gelatin. Now I always like to make 4 bottles at the same time, So I can use 1 kilo pack of sugar, 1 pack of gelatin, and just a liter of water, just to make it super simple. This way I always have a second bottle on hand. So we're gonna warm up the sugar and the water until the sugar is dissolved. And in the meantime, we soak the gelatin in cold water. So when the sugar is dissolved and the mixture is warm, then we can add our soaked gelatin, give that a good mix, and then we can turn the heat off and let it cool down. It's important that we let it cool down, because if you add the hot mixture to the plastic bottle, the plastic can start melting. So once it's cooled off, we can add it to the bottle, and then we need to put our bottle in the fridge to let the gelatin set. Once we're ready to start, we can take the bottle out of the fridge, and then we can start making our yeast water. So what I do is just take a liter of lukewarm water, and to that add a teaspoon of sugar, just to give the yeast something to eat. And then we can add our dried yeast. I usually add about 1 or 2 grams. We'll give that a good mix and let that sit for a little bit. And then we can add it to the new bottle. Okay, so once we've added that yeast water to our sugar bottle, that's when the whole process is gonna get started. That's when the yeast is gonna start making CO2. But it can still take quite a long time before we actually start seeing CO2 bubbles coming out of our diffuser, because we need a lot of pressure to build up in our system. So this can easily take up to 24 hours. If you're not sure if it's working, you can always squeeze the larger bottle. If you feel the pressure is gonna build up, then you know it's working. And just give it a little bit more time before you will start seeing CO2 bubbles. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the downside of this system and why people stay away from it or don't recommend it so much. So one of the biggest downsides is the fact that you can't really turn it off at night. So you're gonna have CO2 bubbles running 24/7. And this can be dangerous for your fish, of course, because at night the plants are not using CO2, so you're not gonna have a lot of oxygen in your water. But if the CO2 levels keep rising, and then there's a chance that your fish are gonna basically choke. So to make sure that that's not gonna happen, we need to bring more oxygen into the water. And the easiest way to do that is just by creating decent surface agitation on your water. If you just raise your filter outflow a little bit, and you're gonna create that surface ripple, that's gonna bring plenty of oxygen for your fish, so you don't have to worry about choking them with your CO2. Another reason why people do not like these systems is because according to them, you can't regulate the system. You know, you can't open a valve and increase the CO2 bubbles or decrease. But we can regulate this in other ways. We can add more yeast, we can add more sugar, or we can add less sugar and less yeast. This system is very sensitive to temperature. So if we increase the temperature of the bottle, then we can also increase the CO2. We can just increase the CO2 by just giving the bottle a little bit of a shake and increase the pressure. So there's a lot of ways that we can still control the amount of CO2. Of course, it's a little bit more difficult than just opening or closing a valve. But yeah, what do you expect for a CO2 system that costs less than $5? You know, if you don't want to spend money, then you need to make some sacrifices. Another thing that I hear very often is the fact that it's unstable. Now, because we've added the gelatin to the mixture, this is actually what makes it very, very stable for a very long time. Of course, at some point it's gonna stop working and the amount of CO2 that we're gonna get is gonna decrease. So what I always recommend is to, once you start noticing that the CO2 is gonna decrease, and this is probably gonna happen in week 5 or week 6, just change it for a new bottle, you know? Just get a new fresh bottle and then you're gonna have a stable amount of CO2 for a long time. And what I also recommend is when you're gonna change it for a new bottle, make the fresh bottle a day in advance. So this new bottle has about 24 hours to, you know, get going, get started. And also, when you're changing the bottle, for a fresh one, do this in the evening. So in the evening, when your lights turn off, then remove the bottle and swap it for a new one. So it has the whole night and the first few hours in the morning to build up the pressure again in the bottle, in the system. So once the lights turn on the next day, you'll have a stable amount of CO2 coming out of your diffuser. So yeah, I think that's it. I'm gonna write the whole thing step by step in the description box, so you can read it again if you have to. As with everything, there's 1,000 ways that you can do this. You know, you can also do it with citric acid and baking soda. That's a completely different method. You can also replace the gelatin sheets with gelatin powder. Yeah, this is how I do it, and I've been doing it like this for many years and had great results with it. If you have any more questions, drop them in the comments below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care. Bye.